Hey, what's up, everybody? Chris Broderick here, and I am doing the riffs that taught me. Couple of things about these riffs. Back in the day, I was only on six strings, so I was playing them pretty much like, or at least I was trying to play them, pretty much how they were played on the instrument. However, today, I just wanted to let you know I'm on a seven string that's a half step down. So for some of the drop D tunings and stuff like that, I'm going to be just converting those to the seventh string because I have it. So why not use it, right? At any rate, I hope you guys really dig these riffs that I grew up with and that I love to play. And yeah, let's get into it, all right? These are the riffs that taught me or schooled me. The first one is a riff by a band called Ratt. It's called Lay It Down, and I can remember spending hours trying to review the VHS tapes for those of you under 30 or 40 even by now. Might not even know what those are, but they were cumbersome for sure, and trying to rewind them and get them to play exactly where you wanted them to so you could just barely see what the guitarist was doing was such a pain in the butt compared to what we can do today. At any rate, I'm sure, as with most of these riffs, I didn't play it correctly, but I tried my best at that time. This is Ratt's Lay It Down. So what was it that I really dug about Lay It Down? One, I mean, it was just such a cool tune, and the guitar tone ruled. And the one thing that really caught me when I was learning the song, or trying to learn the song, was all the extended chord voicings that I didn't even really know about, that you could even do with distortion on the guitar. So for example, a sus4, sus2, you know. That was really my first exposure to those particular types of chords. And then, of course, that extended first inversion major chord up to a C major. So all of that stuff to me was like really new and just so over the top inventive. Another thing that I really liked about this song, even though I couldn't have labeled it back in the day to save my life, was the idea of modal mixture that was going on here. So he starts with a D major chord, but then he borrows the 6 and the 7 chord from the relative minor. And what a cool sound that creates, you know? At any rate, that's what I dig about Ratt's Lay It Down. Hope you guys like it. The second riff that schooled me was King Diamond's Mother's Getting Weaker off the album Them. And I can't really say too much about this particular song because the whole album is insanely good. I listened to this song and this album nonstop throughout my last high school year and just loved every minute of it. You could take any song off this album and learn a lot on the guitar with it. I loved Andy LaRocque's vibrato. Just so much. At any rate, let me play this riff for you and we'll talk a little bit more on the back end. So So to me, that riff was really interesting because it flowed so nicely, but at the same time, it didn't feel like really typical or anything like that. And it wasn't until I was looking at it recently that I figured out that he kind of has this extra 2-beat bar that he inserted into that first melody. So if you look at this, it's like, that's where I would think, okay, that's going to repeat. That would make a nice repetition. But he doesn't do that, and nor does he extend it by another full bar. It's just 2 beats before it comes back into like an abbreviated repetition. So he adds this. So it would go. That's the extra 2 beats that he adds. And to me, that really gives it a uniqueness that you don't normally hear in metal. Of course, I love it also because it's our favorite tonality for any metal guitarist. You gotta love harmonic minor. So you've got that too. That was the second riff that schooled me. King Diamond's Mother's Getting Weaker. Hope you guys dug it. You know, it was pretty funny when I was growing up and had started playing the guitar. I started with, you know, like Led Zeppelin. My older brothers were trying to influence me. And then I got into Eddie Van Halen. I was just like, man, it can't get any more crazy than this. And then one day I heard Yngwie and I was just like, I didn't know what to do. Like I knew nothing about that type of playing or anything like that. And so one of the best places to jump on the shred ladder would be I Am a Viking by Yngwie Malmsteen. So this is riff 3 that schooled me. The riff goes like this. So one of the things I love about that riff, looking back on it now, is that it really uses a leading tone in the traditional sense. Now, for you non-music buffs out there, a leading tone is the note that wants to resolve back to the root of the key. So we get this, that D sharp right there, wants to resolve back to an E minor. And so that's, you know, somewhat common. It's used by a lot of guitarists, and it's very traditional in its usage. But the cool thing is that when he didn't go back to the one in this case, when he went to the, he goes to the 6th chord, to that C chord, and instead of using the D sharp, he uses a D natural. And I thought that was really cool. So, yeah. At any rate, that was riff number 3 that schooled me. Speaking of Yngwie, another great riff to jump on the shred ladder would be I'll See the Light Tonight. The opening riff is really cool, and I think it's more approachable to a lot of guitarists. But then, of course, once he gets into it, into the solo, then it's, you know, everybody for themselves at that point. At any rate, this is riff number 4 of the riffs that schooled me. This is Yngwie's I'll See the Light Tonight. One thing that I really liked about this was the work of the development of your independence between your third and your fourth finger, especially for these like... You know, that kind of stuff to me was invaluable in the development of the independence of my fingers. So hopefully it will help you guys out as well. All right, see you in the next one. The fifth riff that schooled me was a riff that still scares me to this day. And of course, that's Racer X's Scarified. I am probably over 100% sure back in the day when I thought I was a badass and, you know, my band played the song out live, that I didn't play it at all correct. Like, I remember not having any consideration for the rhythm at all. I'm sure I just saw it as a flurry of notes and never really considered those kinds of things back then. But it sure was fun to think that you were taking on something so challenging. At any rate, this is Riff 5 that schooled me. Racer X is Scarified. All right, hope you guys dig it. So, yeah, that riff is crazy, but I love it because the idea of mixing 16th notes and then sextuplets and having such a clear delineation between them is really unique, I think. Usually when you do a fast scale run, it's one subdivision and you stick it out with that. So when he picks up the part, you know, that nice little build between the 16ths and the sextuplets, phenomenal. And then, of course, he's got his string-skipped arpeggios at the end by him, I mean Paul Gilbert. Bruce Bellier, of course, did them as well, but I think Paul Gilbert was the one who really, like, exemplified string-skipping arpeggios. So these guys... At any rate, this riff is awesome because to me, it would seem like it's almost born out of the idea of an exercise that mixed those 16ths and sextuplets and somehow became this great song. I hope you guys dug it. This has been the Riffs That Taught Me/Schooled Me, and I will see you guys on the next one, okay?